delighted to have the opportunity to speak with you all again. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Aileen and I'm the Family Support Worker with the Templemore Community Services Centre. Here with me this morning is Sister Mary. Sister Mary worked for many years with Templemore Community Services Centre and I'm delighted that she was able to join us this morning. Sister Mary will speak with you all soon. But first of all, I just wanted to check in, and I know that it's a very difficult time for a lot of people. So we're hoping that with these broadcasts, we can bring some sense of lightness and comfort to your day. And just to remind people that I'm available if anyone wants to ring for a chat, if there's any practical help that people need, just ring the centre and I'd be happy to speak with you. So Sister Mary, in a few moments, will do a reflection for you all. And I just wanted to recite a poem, just a local poem about Carden's Wild Domain. I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with it. It was written by the Reverend Timothy Corcoran. So just a little bit of history about the Reverend Corcoran. He was born at Carduff in Killay, Templemore. And himself and his brother James, they were involved in land agitation in Killay in the 1800s. They emigrated then to the United States, where they both completed their studies for the priesthood. Timothy died in 1928, but he had compiled this piece before his death. So just going to read it now, and as I said, I'm sure you're all familiar with it. Of all the places in this world, no matter where I roam, I love you, dear old Erin's Isle, my own ancestral home. Where'er I stray by night or day, fond memories draws my brain to the happy, pleasant days I spent around Carden's Wild Domain. When autumn shades were golden, it was there I used to roam, where the pheasant, grouse and partridge all find a happy home. The wild jack here, he rises there and scampers o'er the plain, for to test the fleetness of the dogs around Carden's Wild Domain. And the turtle dove sits cooing there upon the tall oak trees. The thrush and blackbird warbles, loud their notes come through the breeze. The cuckoo's notes are heard to sound along those flowery vales and echo all the woodlands around Carden's Wild Domain. It grieves me too to see this land oppressed by tyrant's laws. To strike a blow for freedom would be a righteous cause. To see her sons and daughters compelled to cross the main and to leave behind their loving homes around Carden's Wild Domain. So rise ye men of Barnan and get ready for the fray and join the noble general MacSweeney from Killay. Led on by those great mountaineers, those lands we'll soon regain and we'll plant our homesteads once again around Carden's Wild Domain. With cap and feather trimmed with green, we will march in grand array. Three cheers we'll give for everyone who comes from sweet Calais. Those cruel, tyrannic landlords we'll chase across the main, and we'll raise the flag of freedom high over Carden's Wild Domain. Now, I'd like to hand you over to Sister Mary for a slight change of tempo, and Sister Mary will read a beautiful reflection for us all.
Hello to you all this morning. I am so pleased to join with Aileen in linking with you, especially during these most difficult times. You've been very much in my thoughts and prayers over the past few months, especially those of you who are sick and bereaved. I've been invited to read a reflection, and the one I have chosen is called Footprints. Footprints is a very beautiful poem about having faith in God, also known as footprints in the sand. This shows how God is always with us, especially in times of need. Each of us has our own unique set of footprints guided by the Lord. In this month of November, we remember all who have died, especially our loved ones, those who have died from COVID-19. Their footprints, in good times and difficult times, are carved in the earth. They remain close to us, deep in our hearts forever. As we see from the poem, the Lord is constantly with us, at our side. So perhaps we would take a minute or two to listen to the words of that beautiful poem, Footprints. And after that, we will play a hymn to Our Lady, followed by an old Irish blessing. Footprints in the Sand. One night I dreamed a dream. As I was walking along the beach with my Lord, across the sky flashed scenes from my life. For each scene, I noticed two sets of footprints in the sand, one belonging to me and one to my Lord. After the last scene of my life flashed before me, I looked back at the footprints in the sand. I noticed that at many times along the path of my life, especially at the very lowest and saddest times, there was only one set of footprints. This really troubled me, so I asked the Lord about it. Lord, you said once I decided to follow you, you would walk with me all the way. But I noticed that during the saddest and most troublesome times of my life, there was only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you most, you would leave me. He whispered, "My precious child, I love you and will never leave you, never ever during your trials and testings. When you saw only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you."
Is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand.